Hey guys, Garry Dean, detailjuice.com. Just getting to work on this brand new Audi Q3. You can see she's kind of dirty. It's just a dirty new car.
See all the dirt? The dirt.
Anyway, it's in for the force field protection system. I'm going to modify this deal just slightly. Instead of using Ghost, I'm going to use the Eco Rinse machine right here and the perfect soap to wash her down real quick. And then I'll clean the wheels with some tiger's blood just because that's the standard. I use it in a pump sprayer. And then get it all cleaned up, and then we'll proceed with the force field protection system. So that consists of either the perfect soap or Ghost rinseless wash, then stripper juice, followed by the actual coating, infinite force field, followed by some force field boost. And the coating, my coating, infinite force field, goes on all the paint, all the glass, and all the wheels. Every surface of the vehicle gets the coating, including trim. So it will not bring the black back on trim. However, it will prevent the trim from premature drying out or fading, if you will. So with all that said, I've got my line primed on my Eco Rinse machine. That's pretty important. So basically what I mean by that is I got my water running into the machine, and then I've got my hose for my wand already run out. Then I turn the water on, let it run out of the end of the line to make sure that there's no air in the line. Then I hooked up the wand while the water was flowing, sprayed it, got the last bit of air out, and now the line is completely charged. You should get full pressure, be good to go at that point. Turn the unit on, she pressurizes and should not be airing the line a little bit, and she's good to go. And you guys know I don't feel like soap does any kind of a good job at all, as far as a foam cannon goes. I'm not a fan of it. I feel like it's a waste of time. It does look cool to foam a car, but I think it's a waste. And you know what I'm all about is go ahead and talk directly to the camera for this. What I'm all about is making money. I'm about providing an excellent job to my customer, doing what the customer wants and a little bit more, and making the money and moving to the next job. That's the difference between me and other YouTubers. Most other YouTubers are either enthusiasts, where they're working on their own stuff, maybe maybe they do an occasional job for friends, but me, I'm specifically a money-making detailer. My goal, my mission is to make money. I do have passion with this. My passion is innovating and creating better ways to achieve the job that we've already done for years. And so with my processes and my products, I'm able to do a better job in less time, make more money. And that's what it's all about. So the difference between me and most YouTubers who talk about detailing is they are more what you'd call the weekend warrior, or even less than that, even just an enthusiast. Whereas I am a pro and I own the product line. 813-846-4406 is my cell phone number, by the way. How many other product line manufacturers give you their direct line? None. And you can actually get me on that. Try it. So anyway, I just wanted to tell you just a little bit about what I'm doing and why I'm different than most YouTubers. The other different types of YouTubers out there who talk about detailing are more high-end detailers. They only focus on being perfect to the book, taking as much time as they can by getting things perfect. Well, perfection is not reality, and that's not what I do. What I do is I listen to my customer, I put the effort in to make that customer happy, and even more than that, I make that money, I go to the next one. So that's what separates me from most people. A couple things, just to reiterate. I do this for a living. Every day, all day, I'm detailing cars. When I get a job, I take it, I do it. I'm not just an enthusiast. I have cool shit. I do my own stuff. I'm not a swirl Nazi. I don't worry about all that stuff. What I worry about is what my customer wants. And that has made me successful. So just think about all that. Think about the source that you're dealing with. If you're looking to make money detailing, I'm the guy who can help you do that. These other people on YouTube, now you might get some tips and tricks from them or whatever, but you will generally find that their processes take longer. Their products take longer. Their products probably cost more per dilution. And it's not even important what the product costs. It's about how you feel when you use it. So use what you like. But that's what separates me from the other YouTubers out there who are talking about detailing. I do this stuff for a living. And I focus on making money at it. I focus on making the most money at it. So anyway, Audi Q3 Eco Rinse Machine. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hose this thing down, knock the bulk off, and I feel like this does every bit as good of a job as your foam cannon situation. I don't believe that the foam cannon does any more than what the pressure of a pressure washer or even the Eco Rinse Machine will do. For example, see all that dirt there? Now this pressure is going to remove most of that. See that? Maybe I'll give you a better shot. Now I do not believe for one second that if I were to spray soap on this, it would give me any better end result than what I'm going to do right now. So I'll just go, I'll shoot from here over here and remove what I can there, and then you'll see what's left there. Now this is the worst part. This is not nearly as bad. So now I got the non-bonded contaminants off with just the water. I don't need soap to do this. I'm saving soap, which is saving money. And that's it. I don't care what those other people on YouTube are saying. The problem out there is that you guys all want to get so technical and be too thorough. Yeah, there is a thing called being too thorough. There's a level in detailing where it just doesn't matter. There's a level in everything where it just doesn't matter. You've got to decide, how far do you take it before you start chasing your own tail? Personally, I like to give the customer an amazing job and make them happy. And I like to make my pocket happy too when I'm doing it. I make the customer happy first. Don't worry about the pocket, because the money will come if you're making the customers happy. They're going to refer you. They're going to love the job you do. And they're going to be happy. And that's what's important. So anyway, I'm going to shut my mouth now. I'm going to get to work on this car. I'm going to make my customer happy. So we'll be back. I'm going to load the bucket up with the perfect soap, wash this car, get it all clean, and then I'll proceed with the stripper juice application and then the infinite force field boost, and then she'll be done, good to go, and then I'll vacuum out the interior. All right, time for stripper juice. It's not complicated. Get your towel out, fold it into fours, like so. Try to do this with one hand. I spray it on the towel. These little sprayers have an on-off switch right here. I like to spray it on the towel, then spray it on the surface, or I'm sorry, then wipe it on until you feel the surface get grabby, and that's what you're looking for. Grabby means there's nothing left on there that you're trying to pull away. So get it grabby, move to the next panel, and you're good to go. And so stripper juice leaves behind a primer in addition to stripping anything that's on there off, which allows you to have a bond from this side and then a bond from that side whenever the infinite force field grabs. So, not complicated. Again, stripper juice and a microfiber towel, wipe down the whole car, and then apply infinite force field. I generally don't, well, I do not recommend applying infinite force field in direct sunlight. However, I have the technique down to a science. So I'm going to go ahead and apply it, and I'm going to use a microfiber towel. I generally would require or even recommend, I should say, that you apply it with a dual action polisher, but I'm really good at it at this point. I've been using it for over 2 years. I do have a product that we're working on, Force Field Pro, which is four times as potent as Infinite Force Field, that I'll be most likely offering to pro detailers that are licensed, like legit pros, as a, you know, obviously a pro product. So I'm working on that. That product hasn't been, I haven't field tested that a whole lot. That just came about not too long ago. The chemical makeup is basically the same as Infinite Force Field. It just has more acrylic in it and more hardener. So the biggest difference is it will cure far faster, and it will harden harder, and it will basically look better and be slicker. That particular product will come in a glass bottle, because and with a metal top, because it will cure fast on you, and the plastic will allow air to get in over time, whereas Infinite Force Field cures a little slower. So the Force Field Pro product will have to be applied by a machine, which generally consumers don't have that, so that's the other reason it should be marketed just to pros. But anyway, I may or may not release something like that. I'm still in the testing stages. You know, again, Infinite Force Field is a proven product. It works awesome. People all over the planet love the product. And Force Field Pro is basically the same formula. Well, formula is different, but it's based on the same formula. It just has more acrylic and more hardener in it. So anyway, Infinite Force Field is what I'm going to apply on this particular vehicle. And it is a bad man. It is a pretty amazing coating. It's the best coating I've used, but of course, of course I would say that it's my product, but I can tell you that I have used all the other stuff, and I have the ability to create anything I want. And based on my experience, Infinite Force Field is the best coating that I have ever used. Take that for what you will. It is what it is. So I'm gonna get back to work. All right, YouTube, Detail Juice Nation, whoever's watching this, both, whatever. Anyway, 2016 Audi Q3, Infinite Force Field, or I should say the Force Field Protection System from DetailJuice.com. I washed it with the perfect soap, and I used the Eco Rinse Machine, which is right here. That's available on DetailJuice.com. It's a pretty amazing piece of equipment. It is a half of a gallon per minute flow, 1100 PSI, plenty of pressure to remove bugs and gunk and all kinds of stuff, but not too much. But it also only draws 6.3 amps. Comes with that 50-foot hose, quick disconnects that wand there with the 12-inch nozzle, or 12-inch extension, metal nozzle, and comes with the shroud, so that if you happen to hit the car, which you generally will not, you don't have to worry about it scratching anything. So anyway, washed the car with the perfect soap. I clayed it with my ultra fine Japanese clay bar that I literally import from Japan to remove all the contaminants. After I clay barred it, I wiped everything down with stripper juice, and that removes any and everything that would have been on there from the dealer, or if the customer had applied anything, it will remove that. And it also leaves behind a primer, which helps the Infinite Force Field have a chemical and physical bond, which is better than just having one bond. So it grabs the product, the Infinite Force Field, as well as the Infinite Force Field grabbing it. So it helps it to last longer. And then I applied Infinite Force Field with a microfiber towel over the whole car, and then I went back with Force Field Boost and wiped everything down. smoothed out any high spots. I rarely get any high spots with Infinite Force Field. It cures really fast in the sun, so you really have to be on it. But the Force Field Boost, unlike most manufacturers' coatings where you've got to polish off the high spots because their coatings are solvent based, the Infinite Force Field actually just pushes the bulk of that high spot around and smooths it out so that it doesn't remove extra material. You've got an even surface to deal with, so that's pretty awesome. That only works that way within the 1 hour cure time, so get that Force Field Boost. That's why I recommend doing one panel at a time with Infinite Force Field. You don't want it to cure before you get back to that panel and smooth it out with Force Field Boost, but that's where we're at. Force Field Boost, I'm sorry, Infinite Force Field on the entire vehicle. I have one coating that does it all, unlike most manufacturers that try to fool you with marketing trickery, making you think you need a different coating for every surface. I coated the paint, the glass, headlights, taillights, all the trim, chrome, and the wheel faces with the Infinite Force Field, and it looks absolutely stunning. I also applied Transform Dressing, diluted 50-50 on the tires. That's 50-50 with water, if you didn't know. Tires look awesome. In about 10 to 15 minutes, they dry to the touch. They will not sling product all over the vehicle, which is exactly what you want. So that's it. 2016 Audi Q3. If you guys got any questions, 813-846-4406. If I can earn your business, let me know how. If you need a detail done on a vehicle, give me a call, send me a message, send me a text, Facebook message, whatever. If you want to be a part of something bigger than detailing, check out Garry Dean's Detail Juice Nation. It's a group on Facebook where we talk about only my products, my process, and what we've got going on in Garry Dean land. So again, 813-846-4406. I am different than all the other YouTubers out there. I show you how to make money detailing and even how to improve the process if you're an enthusiast. I'm all about showing you a better way to do business by customer centricity and not cutting things short per se, but just finding better ways to achieve the same end result in less time and making customers happy. So let me know if I can help you with anything. Have a wonderful day, and thank you so much for watching this video. You guys help me each and every time you view a video. I appreciate you. Thanks again. Have a wonderful day.